So Hattie, try to record this really quickly. So you've got all these calculations done for your Ferris wheel project. You've got the time all calculated. You've got the angle of rotation. Don't worry about this. This has to do with radians. I'll show you how to do that. There is a way to calculate radians. It's simply the degrees multiplied by pi over 180. So you would have to know this equation precisely. That's in Google Sheets. That's the way to do it. I'll show you how to do that if you'd like. I've done that for each one of these. What I've used is I've used equals pi parentheses, both open and closed, times the cell that has the radii degrees in it, and you divide that by 180, because the degrees is the radians is simply the pi. Or I'm sorry, the degrees times pi divided by 180. Okay, so we have all these in radians, and that's going to help us find the vertical leg of the right triangle. This does all the math for us. If you've already done the math, you just simply have to plug these numbers in. You've done the math in a calculator. Don't worry about this part. I just did it just to help myself do the math really quickly. 25, it has a function cosine, but it has to be, that number has to be in radians. So these are our numbers in radians. So the vertical leg is 25, and this is the one we did on the board today in class. A is the vertical leg of the right triangle in that thing. We have hypotenuse, which is a radius, times the cosine of theta. Theta, we said, was 0 degrees, so it is 1. 25 times 1 is 25. The height of the gondola is the center height, which we said was 50, minus 25 is 25. All right. So in this one, we have all this information. So here's a good way to do it. Once you have this whole chart completed, this is from 25 at the base height, the 75 at the total height, with 50 at the center height in the middle. All right. So we want to take the information we have in the time column. We want to put those columns side by side. So we're going to use the equal sign. That calls up a function, and it's just going to point at this cell and capture that cell. Okay? And I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to find the height. Use equal sign. I want to find the height of that cell right there, and I'm going to move it over there. And so now notice that it's starting to chart on here because I've already inserted a chart. Now, here's the best part. I can copy, which is Command C, after I highlight those two items, and I can copy them all the way down here to 30 minutes. And it autofills everything. And now look, my chart's all there. But now I want to do three more or two more iterations of this. So we know that time marches on. So first thing you want to do is you want to add 2.5 minutes to the 30. So we point at that cell. So it's going to be equals point at that cell, which is F15, F row 15. It's column F row 15. And then I'm going to add plus 2.5. And that gives me the number of minutes to the next point. Now, in this case, I don't want to go back and look at the height here because there's nothing there. I know that it's a cyclical fashion. So if I go up here to the 2.5, it'll be the same as the 32.5. Now that I have that in there, I've got it. So I'm going to copy the time and I'm going to paste it all the way down to 90 minutes, which I think is the next to the last point right here by hitting Command V. And I have all the times up to 90 minutes. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to copy this because it does everything and it'll actually capture the value that's the perfect number of points away, and I have everything there. And voila, everything is on my chart. Now I can print this out, or I can actually adjust this chart and I can edit it and I can do a few things with it. It's going to take a minute for the edit chart to come in. Give me just a second here. I don't want to edit the chart with my face there. There we go. It says scatter chart. I'm going to make it a